some of the processes will go on for years in aging cheese, in making a richer cheese taste.
The grass outside is giving a special taste to the cheese. It delivers a kind of softness of the cheese in the mouth when you're eating.
A natural product can be so important for a town that the town gets rich from it. It's like champagne in France or beer in Belgium, and we have cheese.
What makes our cheese special is that it's not just Gouda cheese, it is, but it's a Boeren Gouda cheese. Boeren means farmer, and special about it is that Boeren Gouda cheese is a cheese produced on the same farm as where the cows are milked, and we don't heat the milk, so we produce cheese from raw milk. I am Frank Kaptein. Welcome to our cheese farm where we produce echte Boeren Goudse kaas. Real Dutch Gouda farmhouse cheese.
Of course, there are also some ingredients were very important for having good milk and good cheese afterwards. Like the fresh grass they grab outside. It's very important for cheese because it gives a special structure to the cheese while it's really soft in your mouth. My name is Kees Kaptein. My job at the farm here is feeding the cows so that they can produce good and healthy quality milk for making a good Gouda cheese. It takes a little extra attention. If it's raining, I keep them most of the times inside. And if the weather is good, they go out. But I'd rather have them outside, it's better for cheese. And people also ask for me when the cows are going outside from Kees, they already got the cheese feeded fresh to the cows. People like it, yeah.
Roughly every day we produce between 12 to 14 cheeses, and what's special on our milk is that it's totally fresh. When it comes into my cheese making tube, 1 minute before it was inside the cow, and it's raw, not heated, not pasteurized, nothing, as fresh as it can be. Milk sour bacteria and the rennet are, after the milk, the first two main ingredients, and then we use some little bit of extra calcium. Adding rennet to milk, that's the point when you start calling things cheese. So without rennet, there's no cheese. Rennet comes from the young cows, the calves. In order to digest milk, the calf uses rennet to slow the digestion down in his guts. In order that the rennet can do its job, the milk has to be still. And then it takes half an hour. In that half an hour, I take my breakfast with cheese. And when I come back after half an hour, the milk, which used to be liquid, is then solid. When you cut in your finger, there's blood. But when you cut in solid milk, there's whey. And whey is the watery part of milk. Milk contains fat and protein and some minerals, but 90% of milk is water. And the water we don't need in the cheese making process. By cutting, we get rid of the watery part. Our cheese produced today will stay for almost 24 hours inside the wooden mold. This farm was in our family for 6-7 generations. And of course, back in the 1800s, 1700s, they didn't have plastics and not a proper metal. But there's also a big benefit of wooden molds. It wood isolates. So when I take out the warm curd, warm cheese, it's warm. And inside a wooden mold, it stays warm for a longer period.
Mm-hmm.
Gouda cheese is a name that everybody knows. We speak a lot of tourists who are surprised that Gouda is also a town. I am Karel Baarspul. I am sitting here in front of the Gouda cheese experience, where you can learn everything about cheese and the production of cheese. I'm also part of the organization of the weekly tourist cheese market here on the marketplace in Gouda. Gouda became the cheese capital of the world because Gouda is situated in a kind of swamp. And around Gouda there could not grow anything but grass. And what can you do with grass? You buy cows and they eat grass. And the cows produce milk, and from the milk you can make cheese. Since about 1200 there are cheese markets here in Gouda, where farmers from around Gouda, they bring every week their cheeses to this market, and here the cheeses were sold. In the warehouse, in about 1600, there were weighed more than 300 million kilos of cheeses. So that was really big, big, big business.
Right before the new cheeses will get into the molds, we take the cheeses out into the salt bed. Like 18% salt, and it's that salt that the cheese of 20 kilograms just floats into the salted water. We need that to make a crust to the cheese. So the crust dries out, contains some salt, and that makes it better resistant against mold or anything like that. Turning the cheese in the mold is just to get the right shape of the cheese. Turning into the salt bath is that both sides of the cheese are up and down in the salt bath. When you flip it every day, it gets salted equally. And on shell, it's just for not sticking. Turning cheeses is a daily routine in my life. Every cheese we produce is basically the same recipe, the same way of doing things. What makes different in taste is the aging of a cheese. The thing happening inside a cheese is actually the enzymes, which are in our milk by nature, and added enzymes from the rennet, which is breaking down the protein structure. That is what gives the taste. So we have young cheese, 10 weeks, 3 months, 1 year old, 2 year old, 3 year old, 5 year old, 6 year old. And I thought at the moment the oldest was 7 or 8 years in a shell. We produce a cheese meant to store long. There are people who come from the other side of the country to buy here the 7 year old cheese because they think that's the best you can get. When you put it in the fridge, please don't put it in the fridge, but take it out an hour before you start to eat it. The best way to eat Gouda cheese is in the morning and in the afternoon. Slice of dark bread, put good real farmhouse butter on top of it, and not too less slices of real Gouda cheese, and then eat it. That's the best.